Well, I'm a marine biologist and geneticist, and I have a particular love of fish and shellfish that live in cold places like Antarctica. And the fish that I study down there are really, really neat. They are full of antifreeze, which helps them survive the cold waters and stops them, their blood from freezing. And I've also got a whole lot of other changes that they've made to let them survive down there. But we're interested in not only how they survive the now, the present when it's cold, but what happens to them when we warm up their world with global warming. We're looking particularly at the membranes or the covering around their cells. So all animals need to keep those in enough of a flexible state or fluid for bodies to function. And when you take an animal like a fish from one temperature to another, they're meant to be able to adjust the fats in their membranes to go from saturated to unsaturated or the other way around. And we think in the Antarctic fish that perhaps because they've evolved in a very cold but very stable for a long period environment, that they may not be able to do that shift in the flexibility of their membranes as well, so we're looking at that. And we hope that this will shed light on the impacts of climate change on these fish, which ultimately affects our food supply as well.